If you're looking to streamline your web scraping tasks without having to maintain the code, this Scrapy tutorial is for you. In this video, I'll walk you through the key steps of web scraping with Scrapy, such as installing and creating Scrapy projects, extracting product information, handling pagination, and running Scrapy from within a Python script. First, what is Scrapy? Scrapy is a Python web crawling and web scraping framework offering an extensive package for developers without having to maintain the code. Scrapy is mainly designed for large-scale web scraping projects and has the necessary toolkit to extract data, process it, and store it in your preferred format. How to use Scrapy? Now I'll explain how to set up a Scrapy project for web scraping use cases. Creating a Scrapy project for web scraping in Python is a simple three-step procedure. First, install Scrapy. Second, create a Scrapy project. Lastly, generate a new spider for your web scraping target. Let's start by installing Scrapy. Open your Python command terminal and type the following pip command. Scrapy will take a few minutes to complete the installation, depending on your internet connection speed. Once the installation is complete, you can start creating Scrapy projects using the following command. You need to replace project name with the actual name of your project. For example, the next command will create a new Scrapy project named Scrapy project. Executing the above command creates a new folder named Scrapy project in the current directory context and places all the project files in it. To generate your first spider, you need to change your current directory to this Scrapy project folder using the cd Scrapy project command. Now you can generate a new spider with the following command. Replace spider namer and URL domain with the actual name for the spider and the web scraping targets respectively. For example, the following command will generate a books spider with a target URL books2scrape.com. Congratulations! We just completed the initial setup for our Scrapy web scraper. Here is what the project folder looks like. Scrapy project structure. Each Scrapy project has the following files and folders. Spiders folder contains spiders for defining how to extract data from specific websites. Each spider is designed to target a specific website or set of websites. Typically, a spider contains a set of rules that dictate how to navigate the site and extract the desired data. Items.py contains objects that represent the data a spider is trying to extract. Items are defined using Python classes and help organize the data in a structured format. The middleware.py file contains middleware information for request routing. You can also write the custom proxy middleware in this file. Then, pipelines.py. Once the spider completes the data extraction, we need to process and store the data in a structured format. Pipelines define a set of processing steps on data while it is being extracted. Settings.py contains various configuration settings that control the behavior of the Scrapy framework. For example, you can set a user agent string, configure download delay, limit maximum concurrent requests, configure middleware, etc. Scrapy.cfg is a plain text file that contains a series of configuration directives. For example, it includes directives for the project name, the location of the spider modules, and the settings to be used when running the web spiders. You're encouraged to read Scrapy's documentation page for more information on the basic project structure. You can find the link below. Customizing Scrapy Spider. Now, let's talk about customizing a Scrapy project to scrape all the books information on the books store. Before jumping into the coding, let's look at our initial target page. Notice the book title is in the title attribute of the A tag inside the H3 element. The H3 element is enclosed by an article tag with the product pod class. Similarly, the book price resides in a P tag with the price color tag. The target page lists only the first 20 books out of 1,000 books. Therefore, there would be a total of 50 pages. Let's see the bottom of the same page to know the CSS selector for the next page link. The URL for the next page is available in the href attribute of the A tag. This A is enclosed by an lead tag with the next class. Mind this information, we will use it in the subsequent section. Scrapy Spider customization in action. Now let's customize the Scrapy Spider. Open the books.py spider file in an IDE of your choice. Replace the original template script with the following code. The above script contains two generators, the start requests and the response parser. The start requests generator automatically executes whenever a crawl command is issued to the spider. Here, it retrieves the contents from the URL and issues a call back to the response parser. The response parser generator, when executed, extracts the desired product information from the iterable response. When yields for all the 20 products in the current response are completed, it uses the response.follow method to retrieve the contents of the next page. The follow method calls back to the response parser again to extract and yield products from the new page. The cycle continues until the next page link becomes null or empty. You can execute the Scrapy project by issuing a crawl command from the command terminal. We can also give a file name with the all option to write the output to a file. Running a Scrapy project from within the Python script. You might find it inconvenient to issue a crawl command from a command terminal to execute the project. Luckily, you can execute a Scrapy project from within the Python script. The following spider script, when executed, automatically issues a crawl command and saves the output in the books.data.csv file. The start requests and response parser are the same as our previous code. The main serves as a starting point for direct execution. It calls the bookSpiderResult function and waits for it to return a value. The bookSpiderResult works as follows. First, it sets the control dispatcher to execute the crawlerResults function on the encounter of an item scraped signal. The item scraped is generated whenever the spider scrapes an item from the target. Then, it creates a crawler process for the bookSpider and starts it. Whenever the book spider completes scraping an item, it emits the item scraped signal. This causes the crawler results function to execute and append the scraper item to the book's results list. Once the crawler process finishes scraping the items, the book spider result returns the book's results list. The main function on return writes the returned books data to the booksdata.csv file. The book spider is now self-contained, making it straightforward to execute it. Just navigate your spider's folder in the Scrapy project and double-click the books.py file. Alternatively, you can open the command terminal in the spiders folder and run the scrapy run spider books.py command to run the spider. Here is what the output file looks like. Hopefully, this detailed tutorial with real coding samples helped you grasp the basics of web scraping with Scrapy.